Probably. Hey, how are you doing? Yeah, nice switch, don't you think? Okay, I just have a couple of questions about what just happened here for the last 2 minutes. First, this is why I hate technology, but where is it? Okay. Welcome to our event today. Thank you for lending us your ears for so long. I know how tiring that could be. I'm the last person, thank God. My name is Hoda. My session is called Speaking Cats. Any ideas what that means? Yeah. Can you see it? Yeah. Do you like cats?
No.
Maybe from very far away. Yeah. Little cute ones. Okay, so cats are short for classroom assessment techniques. But I thought that would be funny. Yeah, I agree. How cute are they? Yeah, this is how cute this session should be. So, can you guys tell me something? The teacher that just came in and said good afternoon and that. Do you think this is a good teacher? I like that answer very much. I actually appreciate all your answers because all your answers are correct. It depends, right? Would you sit here for an hour listening to that person giving you an assessment technique session? Thank you. How did you reach that conclusion? Thank you. So you made a... Thank you. I appreciate that. You made a judgment call. I do a lot of that in laundry and they're not very good. So... What's the difference between making a judgment and assessing somebody?
Judging is my personal opinion, and assessing regarding their abilities and what they do.
Okay. Okay. What else?
Assessment depends on criteria, but judgment to me depends on personal, and it doesn't depend on criteria or rubric.
Okay. That's fair enough. Judgment
may be positive all the way. Judgment may be positive all the way, but assessment should be perfect, and I'll give bad signs and good signs for them.
Okay.
Assessment have a purpose or an aim, but I think judgment are just giving your feelings about someone or something.
Okay.
Maybe you're.
I can't judge anyone from the first time, but assessment, I have to listen to him and evaluate him professionally. Yeah.
Thank you. May I share my ideas with you guys? They're actually not mine. I quoted them, but whatever. Oh, where am I? What happened? How many times did I click it? Sorry, IT stuff. Doesn't work with teachers, huh? Well, this is what I think about assessment and evaluation. When I'm assessing somebody, my aim, just like what Manny had said, is to increase the quality. And when I'm judging something, it's saying whether or not it fits something. Right? Do you all agree with that? Okay. So our purpose today is to increase quality rather than say if it's good enough for something or not. So let me play something with you and say.
What is your name? wanted to teach. Now, is that a load of bull or what?
No!
So teach!
I can't!
What?
I can't teach them!
Yes, you can. All you gotta do is get their attention.
Work. So does this look familiar?
Yeah.
Do we all have that class in our schools?
Yeah.
Yeah, you wanted to share something? Oh. You wanted to share something?
I'm sharing, but I think this movie is called The Dangerous Mind.
Yeah, it's one of the icons.
From this movie, I start to deal with my students, actually.
Really? Chapeau. Okay, so does this look familiar? Do we sometimes feel like this? Utterly frustrated, about to quit teaching, not remembering why we started in the first place? Yeah, okay, let me share with you why I think this happens. And I apologize for the foreigners in the room, this got to be in Arabic for everybody to see. So, do you think this is a legitimate reason for what's happening in the classrooms? Do you agree with Sultan when he said, where is the question?
Well, not in this particular play, but I know that this is the reason many students don't understand or don't share, because they don't understand, they don't get it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, they might not want to, or know how to answer our questions, but what's our job in this?
Where's the objective? Sorry, but where the teacher's not really set the objectives, I mean, it's not clear to them, and hence he's not able to find, what am I supposed to do?
Right, so sometimes our questions are vague as they can be, and we have to work on that. So, what's wrong with the question that she just asked? تعرف إيه عن المنطق? Okay, what else?
Yes, general question.
Thank you, I love you so much.
Too general, too wide to answer. She was not specific about anything, and he said, where is the question? He was very specific. Right? I agree with him, actually. 30 years later, of course. Okay, so this cat, we need to tell this cat what was wrong and how we can fix it. Everything was wrong, just like what you said with the question. I love this cat, it has all the answers on Facebook, so. Okay, let's do an experiment, because I've learned that in order to understand how learning happens, you have to go through an experience yourself. Okay, this is the core concept of teaching and learning. So, I prepared a little experiment, and forgive me because it's a little bit extreme, but it's gonna get you to where I want. What's the first thing you notice when you have a conversation with someone in English? Yeah, the pauses, the tensions, huh? What else? Okay, great. Huh?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, elesma, I like that very much. You guys have to tell me what's mine is after this is over, okay? So, let's listen to this video and tell me what do you notice first.
Once upon the time, I was walking in the street. When I was walking in the street, I met a beautiful girl. The girl loved me, I loved her. We went to the mahzun, we married. After we married, we brought 6 children. After we brought 6 children, one of them died, and the other one is not dying. There is no dying, he's dying. I have 2 eyes, and I can see the dog, the monkey in front of me. Okay.
This this is exactly how. I know, and other people on the streets, and they do not realize what they're doing to our ears and brain damage, cell by cell. Yeah, I like this? Okay, sorry. Never use the microphone, I always use my voice. Huh? You want to say something? Go ahead. Yeah. Yeah. We've lived with the English for 82 years and we still don't know the difference. Yeah, we're going to see that in a while, trust me. Okay. So, when we encounter somebody who has these kinds of problems, you know, everything that, like what you said, how can we better design assessment activities? As you've all read in my agenda, my focus is on pronunciation. Repeat after me. This is my favorite quote of the world. And vocabulary. So how can we better design assessment activities for those two things, two main points? I picked the hardest ones, I know. Okay, let me rephrase. If we want to assess a learner's, you know, pronunciation progress or vocabulary use, how can we better design those activities? I see a lot of hands. Okay.
Listen.
I think we can design it as a form of authentic activities or authentic tasks in order to give them input and to address their needs, not to bring something very far away from their own or their real needs.
I love that. To be authentic in the materials that we've been using. Okay.
We can ask them to pronounce minimal pairs.
Okay.
We can ask them to pronounce the and the for think and zinc and so on.
That's fine. I'm going to use it. Okay.
For me, the best way is twisted tongue.
Tongue twisters, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah, Peter Piper picked a pickle peppers. Yeah, yeah, I love that one.
If I want to design an assessment, there are some characteristics and characteristics that they it should be there. Like authentic.
I'm gonna go to you.
Okay. Actually I wrote them. So it should be authentic, qualitative, self-environment, ongoing, observation, fair, efficient, affirmative, valid, simulative, learner-centered, and reliable. So these are some characteristics that they should exist in any assessment you're doing.
Can anybody add to that?
I think they need to realize the gap between their knowledge and what they have to do. So they have to listen to, for example, native speakers, and then they have to listen to themselves speaking. So they realize that there's a difference between what they are saying and what they should say.
Like 30 minutes ahead of my presentation.
We've got also to personalize and make it interesting so that they are willing to do the assessment.
God, I love girls in class. Related to the student's abilities, actually.
Okay.
I guess the teacher can think a little bit ahead of the level of the students. Like, for example, my students are upper intermediate and their English, some of them, the English is quite, you know, weak. So at one point they had to stop and work on phonetics. I had to introduce phonetic transcriptions to help them to be able to read from the dictionary, whether online or hard copy. They have to be able to differentiate between sheep and cheap, for example. Yeah.
I like the idea of having a role play or a presentation and then videotaping students and then letting them reflect on their videos and see what problems they have with pronunciation or vocabulary.
There's one answer I'm still looking for.
We can assess stress, like produce, present, present, refuse, and so on. And we can also assess the intonation. How are you? How are you? And so on.
Thank you. Oh, sorry. Trying to take as many as possible.
I think we should be realize the importance of I think exposing or giving it students a chance to speak, to have conversations with native speakers for fluency.
Okay. Gonna go to the, hold on a second. Sorry. Just trying to get as many people as possible.
Well, one person said qualitative, but basically does the pronunciation interfere with communication? If you understand them, then it's valid, right? So I would, maybe that's the point you were looking for? Okay, anyway, I think, you know, there may be defective, if we define it that way. But as long as you understand, it flows. I mean, not to say that you should stop working on the BP, you know, these other problems, but if you understand it, they did communicate.
Okay.
Through games and the teaching aids, we can assess their pronunciation and vocab.
You guys have a lot to say.
It's better to max between skills when you are teaching. To make, for example, if you want to teach something, you can mix it between pronunciation and vocabulary. It will be good. And you can integrate also speaking inside this. Mixing skills, it will be better for them.
Okay. We'll have plenty of questions, trust me, to answer. Okay, so I was actually, I tried this in my own classes and I went the simple way and I just asked them, just got feedback from my learners. What is the word that you learned and that you liked or stuck to your head, when, where, and why do you think it's a special word? Why did it stick to your head? Some of the answers that I got, because I liked what it means, because I couldn't write it right the first time, and I got it wrong so many times before I was able to get it right. Some other people said, because the book I was reading was interesting. So from the answers that I got, I felt that it had to be personalized. It had to be related to the learners. In order for them to learn, acquire more skills, they have to care about it. So, yeah. This is my core idea, is to actually make them empowered in their own learning. My colleague has already talked to you about the use of rubrics. Does anybody have any questions or wondering what is a rubric? Can I make my own rubrics? Yes, indeed I can. Is there a resource that can help me do that? Yes, I've actually prepared one for you just to show you that you can customize your own rubrics. I have an experiment and we want to apply a rubric right now and see what we can do with it. Shall we? Okay. I'm going to need help just distributing those. So this is a customized rubric, very simple one. I picked 3 points only, and it took me 5 minutes to do on the internet. Can you please read it? Just go through it really quickly.
Thank you.
just read it, make yourself familiar with it. So, are you done? Just do this and I'll know. Yeah. Beauty of helium, huh? Okay, so this is a question that I gave to one of my learners, and she was supposed to answer and include those points. You're going to listen to her answer and score on the rubric. After we're finished, I'll show you the model, and then you can compare. Don't worry, you don't have to have the exact same answers, as long as you can discuss it and justify your answers. I've learned that too. So. Oh, okay. What stage? That's a good answer. What if you don't know? What if you're assessing her to put her in a stage? Can we just listen to her, please? Just a minute.
There is a confusing part in the rubric because it speaks clearly. She spoke clearly, but the mispronunciation. You said here, no more than one word.
Yes.
But she did more than one word. So how come you put here two? And she did really. She spoke clearly.
I could understand her. See, but the pronunciation. So you confuse. I think it's confusing here. This part.
Okay. So, for you, you could adjust that. When you're doing the rubric itself.
Yeah, I'm doing this one.
Yeah. I know. Okay, I'll show you my ideas and we'll discuss it. Okay. Okay, that's a good question. We need to answer that.
Actually speaking, I consider her a good student, apart from her mispronunciation.
Mm-hmm.
She has very good sentences, very well-formed sentences, and she speaks clearly, and we got the message. The idea is that, we got the message.
Okay.
Work on her pronunciation more.
Okay, I'll give each group 5 minutes to discuss their answers, come up with a final one, and then we'll discuss it all. Okay.
No. The audience here means anybody who generally speaks English, but this part, I'm going to explain it more in the next part. It's about the use of vocabulary and the grades part. Can you please fill them in? Can you please fill them in? You can ask me if you want anything. You can ask me. You can ask me if you want anything.
Okay. Hey, balloons. Shaking balloons. Okay, great. Okay. The beauty of using rubrics is that we don't have to agree on a strict number. Sometimes we can mix between two grades. I can give somebody 2/1 because he did this part, but he didn't do that part. So they would know which part they didn't do. Okay, so shall we see the model? And this is what I thought. I'll tell you why. Why did I give her three? Because she used the word petrified. We're talking about vocabulary, the first one. She used the it wasn't clear because of the pronunciation, but she used the word petrified, and I thought that deserved that she used number three. In the second one, I agree with, what's your name again, I'm sorry? Yeah, Amira. Amira raised a really beautiful point that I was not very fair to my learner, that she spoke clearly 94%, but she did mispronounce more than one word. So we can go 2/1 and explain why. We can go 2/1 in this part. Do you all agree?
Yes.
Okay. You do not agree on one because you didn't hear the word. Right, yeah, this is the problem when learners do not enunciate what they're saying. I know because I was there. The last one, I thought she deserved a 2. What do you all think? Okay. I'm sure that most of you noticed the grammar mistakes. Yeah, we're trained to do that. Hey, I mean, sure. Can we listen? Okay, what do you think? Okay. Okay, I agree with that too. Hmm.
In doing this rubric, is fluency is taken into consideration?
Hmm.
Because in fluency, we don't judge it the same way as written.
Yes. I'm a bit harsh, I know.
And one more point regarding the ratio between the number and the percentage. Number 2 in the second one speaks clearly that the ratio is 10, between 85 and 90.
Yes, very close.
And the other, number 3 and 4 are the same, and number 1 has nothing.
Okay.
So we would have changed this to be fair enough in the ratio between the numbers.
Yes, I agree with all that. These are all sound ideas. Speaking over your heads, you mean?
I'm not intending to explain them or telling you any new information. So what's the point of giving you words that you don't understand? I don't think this is a good thing to get high mark on.
Well, here is not about that point. I understand what you're saying. It's not really nice to talk over somebody's head, which means you're using language that's not familiar to them. But here, it's talking about the classes of vocabulary, which we're going to look into later. So you guys are so way ahead of me. Yes?
Yeah, but is it just realistic? Because someone who said petrifies, would she say prepare in the way she said it? I thought she's reading something. She's not the one who's giving the structure because it was a bit complex. So how she would pronounce in that way and give such a complete sentence?
Yes, she did. Actually, she did. She has flawless language, but I asked her to make mistakes specifically in pronunciation and vocabulary. So it was a bit of a complicated task. She's my friend now. Okay, so again, this is just a sample rubric. It's not something that you have to abide by. You can go create, edit, do whatever you want, create your own criteria, and you know your own learners. But the thing that I would advise is make your learners comfortable, you know, familiar with the rubric beforehand, so they would know what to expect. This is my idea. Okay, let's move on. Yeah, pronunciation, that's my favorite. I got this idea, and I hope you guys agree that it's a good one to use. Have you heard of speech recognition programs?
Yes.
Okay, they're built in every Windows system.
Yes.
You don't have to download them or anything. And they also have something called text-to-speech assigned in the same program. So I'm going to show you a demo of how to use that to improve students' pronunciation and use of vocabulary. I know. I was looking for something built in the computer that you don't have to download. It's not a software. And you can also control the language and the accent, because the built-in program has versions, female, male reading, or British, American, Australian accents. So you would know the source, because the internet is really varied, and you cannot rely on it.
This program can recognize some words.
Well, I'll just watch this.
It can write something else that I said.
Okay, this is why I prepared this demo, for you to understand how to use it exactly the way you want, without any noise or interference with accent problems. We're going to use text-to-speech first to input the data into the speech recognition to avoid accent problems. This is opening a word pad. Just put the text you want in there and highlight it. Start menu, type narrator in the search bar. Here it is on the top, just click it.
Text sample, WordPad window. Focus on last January. I was assigned to present on a health topic at Halliburton Health Safety and Environment meeting. I considered it the most important event in my career because I was having a presentation in front of 500 people. I had a week to prepare myself and my slides. During this week, I started collecting data and working on my slides, working on myself to present well.
You've got the idea. There are minor things like stress and stuff, but they're very, very minor. They can use them to guide them in how to say what they want to say in the right way. And you can choose the accent, the speech, the pitch, and everything. Okay. Oh. Did I skip too much? Okay. The variations, how can I use that in so many different ways? In speech recognition, basically was designed to for you not to type on the keyboard, just to say a command and the computer does it. So I thought we can use this in actually training our students in their homes without us on pronunciation. They have the text-to-speech, you can teach them how to use it to understand how am I supposed to say that word. And then they can practice with the speech recognition. I'll show you again how. Oh, sorry. Just opening a word pad for him to speak or for her to speak, and then the program will actually type for them. The same way, speech recognition in the search bar. Can you see that on the top? Just activate it, and when the learner starts speaking, it's going to start typing. once you activate the program speech recognition, just activate it and start reading or talking.
Last January, I was assigned to present on a health topic at Halliburton Health, Safety and Environment meeting. I considered it the most important event in my career because I was having a presentation in front of 500 people. I had a week to prepare myself and my slides. During this week, I started collecting data, working on my slides, working on myself to present well.
You might ask, why would they do that? Basically, because if they mispronounce the word, it comes out wrong. So they would know which word is wrong and why was it wrong. So if they say Beeble, I tried it, it's going to say Bieber, like Justin Bieber. We're not going to be happy with that. So they have to figure out what was wrong with the word and then do it again. If they don't know how to do it, they can go to the text-to-speech, type it and ask it to read it for them. So it's completely without your assistance. They can train themselves on this at home. And I have a surprise for you. It's built in every smartphone you can think of. It's built in. You can do it. But the smartphone uses an internet engine, which might understand some of the mispronounced words because it's common. This is highlighted. These are the words that were mispronounced. The student, after he finished, because he knows the text already, he highlighted the words that were written in the wrong way. See what I mean? Good. Hope you liked it. What? It's actually very simple. Have you heard of this? Word clouds? Boy, I love it. This is our learner's word cloud. Just wanted to share it with you, what it will look like. Some people, I use this to help my learners visual word most. Because sometimes they recycle the same words they know without adding any more new vocabulary. So the bigger the word means that they've used it more often than they should. An added value. Fun time. Yeah, we cannot ignore the teacher-induced mistakes. We have been profiled very badly in the movie industry, right? We need to change that. So I'm just going to show you something. Hope you like it.
Milena, Bettina, Daniela, Brown, Bonnie, Delaney, Lafeta, Bihar, Bifa, عمل زي الفيلم كلنا مش نفتاحة.
Yeah, we've got to change that. So, I see no problem in my own problems. If I have a problem, there's no problem to fix it. So, I can also use the speech recognition text-to-speech to, you know, like polish my accent if I want to. Because some teachers would love to use the British one, the Australian one, the American one, the Queen English, whatever. Just do it. So, just thought Ahmed Helmi was the co-factor in both movies. So that was fun. What's the next best thing in speaking? If walls were made of bricks, speaking is made up of words. Yeah, that's my passion, actually. What happened? Okay, this is a game that I actually created. Could be a stupid one, but it worked really, really good with my my learners. I'm just going to walk you through it because we might not have enough time to do it in class. Just I asked my learners to sit in a group like you and think of their favorite word. How did they pick it up? Share it on a group grid. And as a team, find correlations and make a map. So if we have a group of six students or learners, everybody's going to have a different word, typically. I need them to find correlations between those words, like a visual thesaurus. Have you heard of visual thesaurus before? It's really, really beneficial. They have to brainstorm a lot of other words to get the connections between the words, and they also have to explain why they love this word and how did they learn it, and I can get to learn how they learn best. Do you get my point? So this is basically what I mean. Now I have a game, an actual game for you guys. So I'll need volunteers to stick them on the walls. Just one for each group on the wall, please. I hope the BC doesn't mind. Just one on each group's wall, if you may. You can put it on the... Amini, do you want to put the balloon up? Just put it on the chair. You want to put it up, the balloon? What do you need? What can't you find? Maybe it's underneath. Thank you. See a lot of helping hands. That's more than you need. Okay, so every group is secured with a card. Show of hands if you're secured with a card. Okay, great. So, everybody has a different context. This is what I call context. This is a picture of a context. I need you as a group in 5 minutes to brainstorm as many words as possible related to that context. Not the place, the context of that place. Really, really quickly in 5 minutes, please. Include this part, girls. You have all the intelligence, but you need to include them. I apologize for the Arabic videos. I know that was...
No.
Oh, great, that's awesome. I wanted to put subtitles, but time was really... Oh, yes, that's very famous, yeah. It's like the icon.
That's just crazy,
you know? I would love to make you understand. We're in Egypt.
That's right.
That's right.
We respect that.
Thank you.
language at least.
Okay, we're gonna have to rush through this for the sake of time. Oh no, please, no, please, no! I'm gonna have a heart attack. Okay, I believe that silence speaks more than words, so. The part when you guys were talking about, you're gonna take mine in exchange for that because this one blew up. Okay, you remember the point about vocabulary, which vocabulary is suitable for which audience? This was not about who's listening, this was about this, the cake, as you can see. The level of the vocabulary that they're using. So I'm gonna give you a handout that explains the same things on the slides here. You're supposed to go through it, and then I'm gonna give you this to fill in the words that you have brainstormed, okay? Once you fill in this grid, you're gonna score yourself based on a criteria that I'm gonna give you. And this will help me assess. And I can do this more often, so I can see the progress. How many words are in tier one, tier two, and tier three? Do you get the point? I'm sorry that I have to rush through it, but I wanna give you everything. So, you guys can distribute that and that. Thank you, just take a copy and pass. Okay. This one? Ah, you want me? I thought you wanted me. You wanted the slides. Oops. I had an interesting question today about collocations. You know how hard that is for our learners because there are no rules. Really? We're going to be friends. Collocations is one of the most challenging things to teach because you often get the question, why and how do I learn it? So I thought of adapting an already existing activity for grammar, and then we can do it for collocations as well. It's called collocations auction. Auction. You know the auction? The guy who has the hammer? Besides the judge? Yeah, I wish I had that one. Okay, can we go a little bit faster with the handouts? Thank you, appreciate it. Just want to show you a different activity for collocations. And you can also adapt it for vocabulary, different levels, it doesn't matter which level you're teaching. Okay, are we all set? Balloons. I love when I say balloons, people raise their heads up. That's nice. Okay. So, may I have your attention, please? This is called a collocation auction. Have you heard of grammar auction before? Some of you might have. Basically, an auction is selling something for the highest bidder. I have here a list of 10 sentences that include collocations. Some of them are wrong. Some of them are wrong, but they're very challenging to find out. I'm going to raise the bid on them. I'm gonna give each group $1,000, and they have to come up with a strategy because the group who buys the largest number of correct sentences win. So they have to really think about it, analyze the sentence, even fix it if they can, and then buy it. Okay, so each group has $1,000 and I have 10 sentences. I'm gonna raise the bids on the first sentence so they have the handouts in their hands. They may need to make the decision of which sentences they wanna bid on. And the highest the bid, they can just challenge each other and see until they run out of money. And at the end, we'll calculate how many correct sentences does every group has. Half, sorry, that was a lousy mistake. So this is the main idea, just hide the incorrect sentences between the correct sentences and challenge them. If they can find out what's wrong with the sentence and fix it, they can buy it. And they get a bigger bonus or, you know, like credit for it. So I'm just gonna pass on this. You understand what I just said or does it make sense? Doesn't, okay. So let's distribute this first, where it is, where is it? Can you just take a copy and pass? Thank you, sorry. Thank you so much for helping. Thank you so much. Everybody has got one? Can you please just pass it on, pass it on? Got one? Sorry. Okay, let's go through it again. Everybody's got the list. I'm going to open the auction. And then we're going to go for the first sentence. So, okay. Each group has already decided which sentences they want to bid on. So when I open the auction, I'm going to say number one, and we'll see who's going to raise a bid on it. And if nobody claims it, we're just going to skip it until the next one and the next one. I have already 10, and I'm going to tell you my secret. 6 of them are right, and 4 of them are wrong. So nobody can ever be even. No groups can be even. I designed it in a way that one group has to win, so they have to challenge each other. Okay? Good. Just 1 minute to go through it. You guys want to read it, huh? Oops. Too much?
Is it too much for you guys? Yeah. Really? Why? I thought we loved paper.
You're out of track.
What?
You're out of track.
What do you mean out of track?
Oh,
I know, I'm at the end, I know. I'm supposed to be the clown, I understand. That's why I brought balloons. I'm gonna have in the nose at the end.
Okay, you don't have to solve them right now, you know? We cannot resist, can we? Okay. Now, the last thing I wanna share with you guys is the inspiration that I got from the movie that I watched. Dangerous Minds. Can I have your attention, please? I'm sure this is gonna move you.
Bob Dylan.
Hi. Well. Welcome back. It's the 29th day, the last day I have to come back. So, am I still okay for next term? Yeah. Did you come back because it was your last day, or did somebody ask you to come today to talk me into staying? Well, it was both, really. See? Because I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do until I heard that you. Up until then, I don't know, I thought that you'd always be here for me, you know?
She was quitting her job.
But then Raul tells me that you're leaving. Just like that. And I realized that this is my last chance. And I decided. We decided. That I'm not gonna just let you leave like this.
say you can't give in. You can't give up. But we ain't giving you up.
No way. Now listen, baby. We're going to have to tie you down to the chair and gag you because you know it won't you to stay.
She had this idea, rejects from hell, kids, and I can't get... Yes, but we get addicted. We can never stop doing this. Don't fool yourselves. If you do it, you're already hooked. So this... Yes?
Can I say a Chinese proverb that is always in my mind?
Sure.
Okay, children or students, children doesn't care how much you know unless they know how much you care. So if you show them that you care, then you like...
Yes. 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 I'm sorry again. Yes, I agree. The last thing I want to say, just thank you for lending me your ears. I know that's been hard all day, and I have something for you. You know, like teachers, we never get anything; we always give. So I thought of preparing something for you. It's very, very simple and small, but I hope you like it. This is a bookmark that I created actually with my awesome friend, Engineer Mohamed Mohi, behind the scene, who actually did all the IT work and he edited all the movies and he did everything possible for me. He made the tutorials and they're going to be available on the Facebook group. This has my email and a quote that I believe in about education. And you can just click on the group and you'll find all the resources and the links and the videos and everything. Just thank you so much.
Thank you, Hoda, for... What about the balloons? Can they keep them?
Yes, they can keep
them.
Okay,
just to bring this one.
I'm so sorry, I forgot to give you one extra thing. These are other handouts that I picked out for you, other variations for using vocabulary assessment techniques. They're just going to be here for you to pick. Feel free. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, everybody. We're coming to the end of the day. Thank you for being a wonderful audience. And thank you, all of the speakers. We're going to give out certificates now. Can I just ask again, sorry, for these questionnaires. This is how we get paid. The British Council, we offer all of these services for free, but we must get these. My job depends on it. Okay, before we go any further, you've obviously been aware of the video camera at the back and you know that this has been shown on YouTube. Well, I've been upstairs watching this and conversing with some of the people who are watching it. And I'd just like to say hello to Rose Youssef in Sohag, who's been watching the whole day, and she's been tweeting about today on Twitter, obviously, but she's watched it from beginning to end, and so hello there, Rose.
Okay.
Certificates?
Yeah. Speakers?
Okay.
Okay, it's now the time for distributing the certificates. We will start with the speakers, and we would like to thank them, and we would like to thank you too. Dr. Ata Gibril. Thank you very much. Mayada, Ms. Mayada. Yeah. Thank you, Mayada. Okay. And finally, Hoda. And now let's move to the certificates for the attendees. And before we distribute them, I'd like to thank you for coming today, for making it in this lovely weather. Okay? Yeah?
British weather.
Yeah. Yeah. Wissam Morsi? Okay, maybe we put them here. Thank you, Wissam. Yasmin Ahmed. Yasmin Ahmed. Hani Yahya. Okay. Pakinam Ahmed, yes. Okay. Rania Khalil, Dr. Rania. Yeah, thank you. Dalia Ahmed. Again. Umayma Ibrahim. Okay, thank you. Hibatullah Hassan. Yeah, Hibatullah. Okay. Adil Salem. Yeah. Nagwa again. Dina Hamdi. Okay. Maha Hassan. Neil, please. Yeah. Yeah. No, no, not yet. Yeah, yeah. Okay, at the end maybe? Okay, I'll notify this. Yeah, it's okay. Safa Mahmoud. Sarah or Sarah? I'm not sure. Sarah? Sarah? Okay, Wafa Farooq. Wafa. Wafa Farooq, she's not here. Noha Fathi, again. Noha Fathi. Khalid Mahmoud El Gamal, yeah, thank you. Nisreen Bahgat, yeah. I think you are coming a long way from Alexandria, yeah. Yeah, thank you for coming. Yeah. She started her journey at, I think, 6 o'clock or 4? 4, yeah. Herculean, yeah. Hibatullah, again. Hibatullah Hassan, I'm not sure. Yeah. Okay. Hiba Tahsin. Yeah, I think Hiba is coming from Alexandria as well. Yeah. Yeah. Ahmed Nouridine. Okay. Shayma Ali. Yeah. Yeah. Rasha Osman. Yeah. Okay. Hiba Abdel Monam. Okay. Ahmed Mahdi. Okay. Maya Atiyah. Okay. Nermin Mustafa. Okay. Hen Samah. Hen Samah Joachim. Okay. Amira Fikri. Okay. Mahmoud Ahmed. Mahmoud Ahmed. Mahmoud Abdel Mawgoud. Okay. After this long name. Yeah. Neil says Mush Mawgoud. Yeah. Yeah. Doha Omar. Okay. Talat Zakaria. Yeah. Basma Maher. Basma. Islam Medhat. Okay. Dina Hamdi. Dina. Wafa Ahmed. Okay. May Mustafa. Sondus Fathi. Sondus. Yes. Finally, yeah. May Subhi. And Maha Subhi. Yeah. 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 Her sister. I recognize the names. That's it. Okay. Hamdi Tantawi. Yeah, Mr. Hamdi. Dua Mansour. Nabila Nakhla. She's not here today. She's not here. Okay. Okay. Ghada Tosun. Yeah. Hind Rabia. Hind Rabia. Yes. Thank you. Osama Fikri. Yeah. Ahmed Ahmed Mahmoud Ali. Okay. Thank you. Rehab Abdul Wahab. Okay. Hoda Mahmoud Abu Hashim, Dr. Hoda, yes. Mushira Muhammad. Amira Tsui. Amira. Yeah, thank you. Maha Gouda. Okay. Shireen Saeed, sorry Maha, sorry. Thank you. Shireen Saeed, okay, okay, thank you. Layla Sirti, Layla. Layla's not around, okay, thank you. Yeah. May Sulaiman, May. Mona Gubba. Mona. Okay. Nagla Siddiq. Nagla Siddiq. Okay. Lubna Adil. Lubna Adil. Okay. Nagwa Sulaiman. Yeah. Muhammad Abdul Majid. Muhammad Abdul Majid Galal. Ahmed Salim Abdul Basit. Ahmed. I think you are coming from Upper Egypt. Yeah. 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 Ayed. Ayed Muhammad. Iman Hanafi. Muhammad Abdul Latif Muhammad Zughbi, yeah, yeah. The last certificate, Samar Mahmoud. Okay. Samar Mahmoud. Okay. I think you are going to fight with me in a minute. But by the way, by the way, just a minute. Hold on. Okay. All the people who registered and confirmed their attendance, now they have certificates, but as you see, many people didn't show up. So if you just register, but you didn't confirm, you will not have a certificate. If you send an email without registration and without receiving an email from me saying you are welcome to attend, this means that you don't have a certificate. But anyway, since you came, just write down your names in a list and emails, and I'm going to send you a soft copy of the certificate. So this is the only way out now. Just write down your names and emails. I'm going to send you a soft copy of the certificate. Just a minute. There is something we would like to share with you since we were talking about blogs and so on. We have a member here, an ILTESOL member, who has a blog and she wants to share with you a slip of paper referring to this blog, and she will be grateful if you got involved.
Excuse me, I have a survey for pronunciation. If you can help me with it on the blog, I'd be thankful. And if you can join my Facebook page, you are always welcome for teaching English. Thank you.